एनी स्टोर, वेदर ऑनलाइन एंड ऑफलाइन, यू वॉन्ट गुड रेंज, यू वॉन्ट टू हैव एन अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ योर टॉप सेलर, ओके,
राइट
एंड मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंटली यू वॉन्ट टू हैव द करेक्ट साइज सेट रेशियो. वी हैव बीन वर्किंग ऑन दिस फॉर ऑलमोस्ट 3.5 ईयर्स नाउ, एंड इनफैक्ट वी हैव ऑलरेडी अप्लाइड फॉर पेटेंटिंग ऑफ आर एल्गोरिथम्स. एंड सो सम ऑफ द अदर बेनिफिट्स ऑफ गोइंग डिजिटल आर बेसिकली यू कैन डू इट इन लाइक ऑल नियर रन टाइम. ऑब्वियसली डिजिटाइजेशन रिजल्ट इन अ लॉट ऑफ एक्यूरेसी एंड ईज, एंड एज आई मेंशन इट्स लाइक ब्लेजिंगली फास्ट, एंड अगेन इट डज मिलियंस ऑफ कंप्यूटेशन टू गेट यू द ऑप्टिमाइज आउटपुट. Just to give you a high level, this is more or less, you know, what the product does. So let me just walk you through this so that you have a roadmap in your mind. So what you need is some master's data. So what is a master data? It could be the list of your stores, list of your styles and SKUs, and maybe some of their attributes. Then it takes transactional data. Transactional data is your SKU-wise sales with applied discounts and selling price. Then planogram, so how many, let us say, categories, what quantity you want to keep in the stores, etc. And then your operating plan. And so operating plan is what sort of revenue you are expecting from all your stores, online or offline. Now, the first step is we do liquidation cleanup. And what this essentially means is that for some styles or products, you might have given a relatively excessive discount. And so all you're doing is recovering your working capital over there. And so our software intelligently finds out your liquidation line items and removes them from the data. And so once we have this clean data, then we can work on the next steps. So the next steps is noose identification. So noose is never out of stock. Essentially, we are calculating your best sellers across an analysis period. The second point is that we calculate cluster contribution at a category level. So before I explain this, we have to understand what a cluster is and why this software is so powerful. Now, if you look over here, we define a cluster as a combination of brand, gender, category, subcategory, and MRP. On a very high level, if you look at a customer's mindset, they are saying, okay, I am male. I want to buy a formal shirt in the range of 600 to 1000 rupees.
Correct.
Then they will think of, okay, I like this pink shirt or check shirt. And so these are the most important things. Now, if you look at fashion, the styles keep on coming in and out. It could be because they went out of fashion. It could be because of supply chain issues. It could be just purely because you didn't get enough ranking for that particular product on a portal.
Correct.
And so style by style analysis for predictions is suboptimal. Right. So here we are talking about, let us say, cluster level analysis, that what kind of revenue contribution you can see for, let us say, cluster one, which means X brand, then men shirt formal 599 to 999 MRP range. So if you look over here, basically it is saying in Jan 19, cluster one contributed to your 20%, cluster two contributed 25%, and so forth. And so we can use like a similar pattern for the next year.
Got it.
So we will let you know what your best sellers are, and then month on month we'll let you know what is the cluster revenue contribution. Now here we are talking about cluster contribution at a category level, right? What does this mean? See, obviously jeans cannot compare with t-shirts, and so when we are talking about cluster contribution over here, it means in a particular category what should be the contribution that you can expect in all the clusters within that category. And then obviously, what is the right size set that you can expect people to buy at a cluster level. Once we have all of these percentages, then we can take your AOP, right? Annual operating plan. And we have the ASP from the last season, and we know the cluster contribution. We can try to predict how much quantity you should have exposed on your stores at a month-on-month level, or conversely, what is the quantity you should be buying, and then in what size set ratio. And so the final part is distribution. This is largely for offline. So there we do three things. One is that as soon as you are moving into a fresh season, then how do you allocate your inventory to these stores? Then within the season, how do you replenish it? And then if you run out of particular styles, what are the right styles to replace with? And again, here the concept of clusters is very handy. So this is our login page. You can come and register your own company over here, and you will get some OTP to do the formalities, etc. Then you can sign in. So we have a demo account with some of our sample data set. And on the right-hand side, you can see, all the various activities that various people may be doing. For example, Kishore ran top seller, Kishore ran as ideal assortment, revenue split, distribution, etc. Very powerful features of the product is the concept of projects. Basically, it is a collection of data that you want to do your analysis on. It's possible that you might want to play around with various scenarios. So, for example, you may want that, hey, I just want to analyze Amazon's data separately. I would just want to analyze Myntra's data separately. So you can create different projects for that. Or you can say, okay, I want to analyze all the data together. So you can just create one project and put all your data in it and analyze it. And so right now, I'll just select the default project over here. Now, if you look over here, these are all the modules that we have. So we have masters, where you upload your master data, then sales data cleanup. Remember, we had that step where we're doing liquidation cleanup. Then your top seller, which is basically your news. And so then your ideal assortment, which is basically doing all your cluster analysis and projecting to you that on a month-on-month basis, for each category, what is your cluster's contribution and what are the good size set ratios? And then revenue split. So let us say, hey, I want to do 20 lakhs of revenue in January in Myntra. This is where we require the annual operating plan. And basically, based on the ideal assortment, we will then project that, okay, how many units you need to procure or buy for every month and in what size set ratios. So let us go to the masters. And so this is what the layout of a module looks like. There is some text over here which explains to you what it does. Then you have inputs. So you can upload your files, data files,
Got
and
it.
then you have your reports.
Got it.
So let me walk you through these one by one. So let us look at masters. So here we are collecting your store information,
Got it.
your product attributes, which helps us do the clustering, then all your styles, then what are the sizes that you use in various categories? Because that helps us do the analysis at a size level also and give you the right size set ratio. Then your SKUs for all of these styles, and then your sales. So just to show you, let's go through them one by one. So let us say you have store over here. So what is a store? The columns of the file has been designed both for online and offline. So for offline, we could have had something like, let us say, a shopper stop over here, because that's your partner.
Got it.
It could be a store in the West region, and you could have given it an IDS SS12, and maybe let us say shopper stop Vadodara. Now, in your case, your partner could be something like Amazon. Your region would be, let us say, global. Your store ID could be, there's only one store, right? Amazon, correct? And you can just say Amazon portal over here. The next file we were looking at is attributes. Remember, in our slide, we were talking about the attributes, right? Using which we formulate the clusters. And so that's all we are asking over here. Let me just expand this for you. So what is the brand? What is the category, subcategory, gender, and MRP bucket? Right now, MRP bucket is like a string, right? So you can put whatever you want. You can say, let us say, put 0 to 5 999 over here, and then let us say 600 to 9 999 over here, something like that.
So
Or you
each
can
is a
all
range.
no, not necessarily. You can also put something like low, medium, high. Basically, just to tell you, okay, how much you are going to sell, let us say, in the low price range or medium price range or premium or mass premium, whatever, right? The next one is your styles. You, all we need is a style ID over here. Basically, now we are tying a style over here to a cluster. So we are asking you the style, its brand, its category, its subcategory, its gender, its actual MRP, and its and MRP bucket.
Got it.
So if you would have used, let us say, low over here, you have to provide low over here.
The bucket needs to, the style sheets bucket needs to match the attribute sheets bucket.
System also does this checking. So you wouldn't be able to upload any line which does not match the attributes that you have already uploaded. Now let's come to the next part, which is your category size sets. This is again very simple. So all it is saying that, okay, for a particular category, what are the valid sizes? And so couple of points over here, these sizes have to be in the increasing order. So our product also takes care of size continuity. And so that's why that increasing order is important. Second, we will be allowing only one size set. And so you will need to manually map. Let us say if you're doing footwear and you have 6, 7, 8 also and 40, 41 also, you'll have to give us only one of them. So let me show you the SKU file. And all SKU is saying that, hey, I have a yarn. It belongs to this style and it sizes this. Okay.
Got it. This is basically like any Flipkart or Amazon sheet broken down to separate sheets. All of this data is anyway taken by the marketplaces. Yeah. So it's just it's simple.
Now let us look at your sales. All right. So all we are saying is that, okay, on a particular date, and then which SKU did how much revenue and how much quantity.
Okay. So I need to enter individual sales data into this Excel. So probably pull it off an Amazon sales report and put it here with the
Exactly. They will give you daily sales, right?
Got it. Yeah, they do.
In the interest of time, I'm not uploading anything over here, but we can walk you through
this, right? Fine.
And so once you've uploaded this, then you can just have like a basic report that, okay, here are your stores, names, partners, regions, and we immediately create some of your clusters also, right? So we are saying that, okay, in this cluster, which is brand one, footwear, formal, male, and 0 to 2699, there are 73 styles. And then size summary, right? This is basically your category size sets. Now sales data cleanup. So again, it has almost the same layout as the previous module. You have like text which describe what it does, inputs required. There's just one more point over here, which is run algorithm, right? So you just need to press on this play button to run the algorithm. And after that, you can view all the outputs. So let us go to the inputs over here. Let us say you want to project for next 3 months, which are going to be June, July, August, right? So you can either choose to analyze your last June, July, August from 2019, or if you want that, hey, our business is sort of a rolling basis, so we want to analyze the last 3 months, which is, let us say, March, April, May. Okay. So you can put any start month over here and any end month over here.
Okay.
So on your total data, which are the relevant month range that you want to do your analysis on?
Okay.
Then max liquidation cleanup cutoff percentage, right? So what does this mean? So as a business, you are saying that I am okay to remove 10% of my revenue as liquidation cleanup.
Like an extra discount or EOSS discount.
Correct. And so what we are asking you is how much revenue percentage you are willing to let go of as part of the liquidation cleanup process.
Got it.
Let us say 6% of your revenue came from highly liquidated sales. So you can say, okay, I'm willing to let go of 6% over here, right?
Right.
And then exit sizes, revenue contribution cutoff. So what this means is if you want to find out your sizes that you should exit, you can say that, okay, I am willing to let go of up to 5% of my revenue in form of exit sizes. So let us say if you are running a chain of 300 stores, and let us say you have in Assam, right? And so there, this might be very handy because you may not want to keep double XL and triple XL over there, right?
Correct, correct.
And so the software automatically predicts it and redistributes the size level contributions.
So let's take if you're doing different type of products also, if you're doing some overcoats and you're doing some t-shirts, the ratio could be very different. If you end up using your t-shirts ratio for overcoat, you may end up holding a lot of inventory, right?
True, true, absolutely true.
So different silhouettes, you get to know in which silhouettes, if you're working on three, four body types or three, four silhouettes, what will happen is this exercise will help you in optimizing all your silhouettes.
Oh,
Now
right.
let's go to run algorithm. Now on your left hand side, what you're seeing is the prerequisites. Once you are here, you just click on the run button. We do yes. So you can see that it's doing, various calculations, computations, and in 10 seconds you are done. Now, if you go to the outputs, now this is showing you your sales summary, right, of your raw data. Right, for a partner, region, month, what was the revenue, what was the discount, and minus the revenue that you gave us, and how many
Right.
quantity was sold in that duration. And so
Right.
basically, you can filter all you want.
Yeah.
Now, interesting thing, liquidation cleanup. Let's just look at this example that for a partner, it could be your Amazon or it could be your Cloudtail or Myntra. Now, in this category, what was the revenue before cleanup? What is the revenue after cleanup? And how much revenue we have cleaned up. Now, this is all the discounted sales, which were never your true potential.
Right.
And so, whatever line items we are left after this cleanup, we are going to do our predictions only on that.
Got it.
And so that's worth analyzing. Okay. Now, exit sizes. So
Right.
you can see that, okay, all of these are exit sizes at a company level, that for this category, brand, subcategory, and this price
Anything
bucket, this was size and it was,
less than 5% shows up over here. Got it.
right? So you can totally disregard at a company level all of these sizes in these clusters.
Got
They're
it.
not giving you really that real hard value for money. Then store exit sizes. Now, if you are running a store, then it is showing you that in a store in this cluster, you should not keep Excel. You should, in this store,
Right,
for
right.
this cluster, you should not keep triple Excel,
Right,
right?
got
Beautifully, only you will see most of the times only the fringe sizes over here, right? Triple
Right.
Excel, double Excel, S, right? You will rarely see like
They're
an
the
M in
danger
between,
sizes. Right. They're always the danger sizes. Small and the
right?
larger sizes. Right.
Right. The next step is to look at your top sellers. Again, you have an input. How much of your revenue should come from top sellers? So here we are
Minimum.
seeing 20%.
Right.
So, okay, so I ran this, done in 3 seconds. Let us look at the output. We end up categorizing all your styles as top sellers or fashion. So let's just
Right.
look at top sellers. And so, okay, these are your top sellers. Now, what's very important is that we are identifying them at a partner level. Your top sellers in Amazon could be very different from your top sellers in Myntra. Then comes ideal assortment. No inputs over here. Just go run the algorithm. It ran in just 5 seconds. All right, so let's look at the outputs. And so what is happening is after liquidation cleanup, after smoothing, after running all those algorithms, this is the right revenue contribution we have come up with for this cluster
Okay.
for this month.
Got it.
All right. The real may be different. The real could have been like 1.8 or it could have been 0.8.
Right.
But we are predicting to you that you should have 1.12% revenue contribution coming in this manner for this cluster, for this store, for this month. Okay. So that's how your.
I like how this thing says 0 to 2699, which is the lower price point, is actually showing a 15% prediction, which I really like to hear, you know.
Exactly. That's a good comparison, these 2 points that you looked at. Now, again, humbly submitting, this is not like simple thing. like it's taking a lot of things like discounting also into calculations to come up with these sorts of distributions.
Right.
I'll just come to partner size set summary. So in this partner, in this cluster, in these sizes, this is your size set ratio, right? Typically, people will do 1-2-2-1, 1-2-3-2-1. But we are giving you right to the decimal point what should be your size set ratios that you should be exposing or manufacturing in.
Got it. It's more in a percentage rather than a fixed ratio of correct. Makes sense. It's pretty accurate, actually.
And you can look at the splits and figure out yourself with respect to sizes. Is this output making sense or not, right? So these are the sizes. Let us say 30 to 36. And this is the ratio in which we believe you should be selling it.
Beautiful.
I'll just go to partner details because from a buying perspective, this is the most important thing. So we are saying that for a partner in this cluster,
okay,
in the month of October, this cluster will have 4.7 revenue contribution percentage.
Okay.
Now, you just upload your AOP over here and just run the algorithm. Completed in 3 seconds, finished. This is now showing to you data at a store level.
Right.
In a store, in a cluster, in a month, here is the assumed ASP. Here is the revenue contribution. So here is the forecast revenue and here is the forecast quantity.
Right.
So you will be selling 13 pieces of this cluster in the store. So distribution mein what we do is that we take your store planogram.
Okay.
Then store stock, right? How much inventory you have in the store.
Yeah.
And then your warehouse inventory. So I'll quickly show you these. So planogram is fairly simple that in this store, now in this store, in this category, I will keep this much capacity.
Okay.
And this is size set quantity that I want 8 pieces to go.
Okay.
Now, why this is important is you remember we computed all those size set ratios, let us say 11:12:15, right? And the system will automatically split this 8 into these ratios to dispatch from warehouse to stores when you are doing fresh season allocation.
Got it.
So very simple data to put, right? Any store will have this data. Then you need your warehouse stock, how much inventory is available for you in the warehouse.
Mm-hmm.
So very simple, your SKU and your quantity, right? Any ERP system can give this.
Right.
Okay. And the final is your store stock.
Okay.
And so this is just saying that, okay, for each store, what is the current inventory I have? And then basically you have your analysis start date and analysis end date. Okay. We can ignore all of these things. I just want to just show you. So you just run this. Okay. This will take about 20 seconds, I think. Actually, distribution module run complete, right? It's just outputting output files, right? Okay. So 37 seconds done. Now, Dhruv,
it's still faster than the offline ERP I am using. My offline ERP takes 1 minute to generate a PDF. So this is very fast. 37 seconds was a breeze.
I'm showing you your distribution summary. All right. So it is now saying that, okay, for this partner, let us say Shopper Stop,
right,
and for a store of Shopper Stop,
right,
in jeans category, you have to send 16 quantity. For what reason? For completing your brokenness.
A size set or something is broken and it's out of stock over there.
Correct.
Okay.
Correct. So now for that Shopper Stop, same store, I'm sending 73 quantity in shirt to replenish because it got sold off very well.
Got it.
Okay. And this does like a lot of interesting things. So for example, it can also increase your width in a store, right? Give more number of options to the client. So I'm sending to the same store, I'm sending 32 quantity only to increase your number of options available to a client.
Right. Brokenness completion is something that we really face sales loss with. So it's not even the out of stock product. It's if a core product like medium or large has gone out of stock, that SKU dips from say 1 lakh to seedha 40,000 in sales or even lesser. So I like this brokenness completion, you know. And we are doing this manually on a spreadsheet right now. What's out of stock, and it's too much work.
Correct. And so again, it will give you a lot of things. So for example, here, you can have some analytics, right? So what was the planogram? Pre-distribution, you had this much quantity. Pre-distribution, you had this much options. Post-distribution, you will have 240 quantity in the store, and your number of options remain the same. Okay, and we were not able to fulfill 12 quantities in the planogram because maybe of lack of inventory. But the most important thing is this distribution action report. I will download the action details. Actually, what this file does is it tells you that for every unit, what quantity has to be sent from warehouse to which store and for what reason. A lot is going behind over here. In distribution, we calculate a lot of things like which cluster sells better in which stores, within a cluster, which are the better styles, then how much inventory you have, right? So let us say style was doing very well, Dhruv, okay?
Right.
But now you are left with only sizes S and M, okay?
Right.
Now that style was very good, but you are only left with size S and M. But there is another style which was doing lesser in revenue than the first style. But now you have the full size intact over there in your warehouse. Okay.
Right.
Which one would you prefer to send to the stores?
The size that's lying in my warehouse.
Right. Because you have the full size set available there, right?
Correct.
And so our algorithms automatically take care of all of these things for you. Yeah. So if you have the data, this is probably not more than like half an hour of exercise.
Yeah. I mean, half an hour of exercise a day.
Yeah.
That's nothing. It's totally fine. 30 minutes a day is pretty good, actually. We spend way more time in actually analyzing all of this manually.
Yeah. And then finally, we have BI dashboards. And so, you know, it is like for all the data, it will show you month-on-month sales category. So it can show you, you know, how your sales have progressed. You can look at the partner level, right? Then you can see how various categories have performed across months for that partner or overall, right? How various partners have been doing compared to each other, right?
Do you guys also take customer returns as a data point to ensure what product is not doing well? You know, there's a particular size that is being returned too much by customers. And should I actually invest in that size or no in the future?
There are two aspects of it. Your customer returned it, but that customer also selected it in the first place. And returns could be a cause of manufacturing, could be a cause of mishandling, could be a cause because the customer was simply experimenting, right?
Right.
And so we don't consider returns as a valid option over here. The value of returns is more, let us say, in planning your OTB, but we are anyway not giving you OTB. We are only giving you a demand forecast.
Got it. So I'm sure if this can accurately predict, which you say it can, it's going to save us a lot of hassle and actually let us focus on the core aspect rather than micromanaging the small issues, you know, which pop up because of our assumption, you know, on these things. So I'm fascinated, you know.